I'll just say that the point of this is, it's really good to understand that if you're outsourcing your authority, like saying I'm too stupid or slow or don't have the time to really come to the answer whether or not I believe what, in this case, Darrell Becker and Shane Radcliffe are saying right now. So I'm just going to go ahead and trust a certain professional who's delivered services to me and my family, medically speaking, for years. Well, that's the appeal to authority fallacy. And that's why it's important to learn some critical thinking skills, without which you're basically a little bit in danger. And I'll also implore the listeners out there to consider that you can actually build an effective healthcare team. And that means it's composed of people who are effective in healthcare. Some people look under the topic of functional healthcare and functional medicine, which includes all types of professionals of various licenses, basically. And some would just look for folks who just get better results. And oftentimes, they do not have the medical degree or medical doctorate, MD, behind their name. They might be, in many cases, a chiropractor. In a few rarer cases, they could be an acupuncturist like myself. I think I could mention there's a one who's been on the Joe Rogan podcast. God, I wish I'd pull his name up. Chris, he's super popular, if you know who I mean, Shane. Who is that? Chris Kresser.
Is that his name?
He's an acupuncturist, big promoter of functional medicine. And that means, you know, doing obviously a lot more lab tests of a wider variety and trying to, you know, gain a lot more focus on results instead of looking through the lens of what is popular in terms of diagnostic and treatment modalities. And I think that that's really important out there, is that you can build a healthcare team composed of a medical doctor who you could use in certain circumstances to get you out of trouble, as well as people who are getting better results. And that could certainly include a chiropractor who's trained in applied and clinical kinesiology, a type of naturopath to hopefully run a lot more labs and be making natural supplements a lot more available, and potentially even an acupuncturist to deliver treatments that are honestly highly likely to help and much less likely to hurt you. If, you know, even if it wasn't incredibly helpful, as unfortunately too many of my colleagues don't get a lot of the job done, my opinion. But there are still great diamonds in the rough that are out there. So you can take control, and actually it all starts with asking these questions to say, am I trusting, you know, an authority that's been indoctrinated? I actually did read all of Jeff Schmidt's book, Disciplined Minds, and now I'm kind of wondering, maybe putting all of my medical hope in this one professional whose literal beginning of his life from, like, you know, pre-med all the way through getting his medical license was traumatic. Maybe putting all of my hope into this traumatized individual is a bad idea. And just because they don't seem traumatized, by the way, that's the same thing as saying I got spanked and I turned out okay. That's a bad idea, you know, to put that hope. You think you're a good judge of character and you know that your doctor is not traumatized? No. There's no going through pre-med and med college without it being traumatic, because every single one of those professionals, myself included, having gone through acupuncture college, can tell you that there's a vast majority of information that we were required to spit out in tests, in classes, and in our board exams that we will never, ever, ever, ever use. And we don't use in clinical practice. In fact, some of it was actual counter to the clinical applications of what we needed to learn to get practical results. That's a big disparity.